I'm Johnny Miller, and this is my U.S. Open.
My father fell in love with the game of golf, and it just seemed like the game for me. I don't know why. I was sort of meant to play golf. And my dad went down to the Army surplus store and picked up some heavy tarp, and he got a mat and a bristle brush to hit off of it, a great big mirror, so I could see what I was doing. And he had the Slim and Sam big book, and he had Byron Nelson's book, and he had Ben Hogan's. I would see those pictures, and he'd have me get me in the right positions. Every evening, I'd hit for about 2 hours, and it was always one more shot. Dad, I'm tired. I've been hitting for 2 hours. Just hit one more. It was always one more. I did that for 2.5 years before I ever even went on a golf course. Finally, I started going to the golf course when I was 7, and that was an important part of my ascension to become a great player. I was winning a lot of the junior tournaments, and a couple of my friends that I played in the junior tournaments, they would take me to Olympic Club, and I knew that was the course that was a U.S. Open course. And what happened when I was 13, they made a special presentation to me to be a junior member without my father being a member. First one ever to have that. To be able to play that U.S. Open course, the Olympic Club, with all those side hill lies and tough greens and trees, and that was really, really important. I won the qualifying at Olympic Club. I was a medalist. I shot 71, and then was up in Eugene, Oregon, just up the coast, and shot 71-68, and was medalist again. And being those medalists were all confidence marks for me to beat all the kids. And so I just sort of breezed my way through to win that against guys all over the country and beat Enrique Sterling in the finals. It just makes you stronger and stronger and more confident. That was a big win for me. The U.S. Open was by far the biggest tournament. The U.S. Open was the one everybody wanted to win. That was the big one. Well, 1966, it was my course. You know, that's the one I knew it better than any pro. I was able to make that qualifying and get to play. And that week was a really sort of an amazing week for a lot of reasons. I got to play practice rounds with Jack Nicklaus on Tuesday, Wednesday. And then I played the first two rounds with Lee Trevino. And after two rounds, I was tied with Jack Nicklaus. And so I got to play with him on Saturday. Can't say that I was thrilled finishing eighth, but then the more I thought about it, I was thinking, hey, that's pretty cool, actually, being low amateur and getting to shake hands with Arnold Palmer. Again, a confidence thing that I could play against these pros. My confidence was rising pretty good. I wasn't there yet, but I was feeling like I could make a living playing golf. My game was good. I mean, I was a U.S. Open player. I was an accurate player. I wasn't a scrambler. I felt like I should win a U.S. Open sometime in my career. I was feeling good about going to Oakmont. I'd heard that it was the hardest course in America, and I was looking forward to the challenge. It's just got every aspect you want to challenge a great player and to show your weaknesses. You're not hitting those fairways. You've got no chance hitting on those greens. And I went into the locker room on Wednesday afternoon to see who I was going to be playing with. And I looked and I said, oh my gosh, I got to play with Arnold Palmer. That was the hardest part about the championship, was just playing with Arnold in his crazy gallery. I mean, those people were Arnold nuts. Being a local boy in the gallery didn't exactly stick around if he made a 20-footer for birdie and I had a 10-footer for birdie to hit it to the next hole. So it was not easy to play with Arnold Palmer, especially at Oakmont in those days. But we both shot 71. I was able to hang in there and tie him. Well, this is the 18th hole at Oakmont. It's a straightaway par four, a long one. And you can see I tried to hit a long drive there and released a little early and hit in the left rough. And I had the nastiest lie you can imagine over there and just swung as hard as I could to put it short of the bunker. And then I got the back left center hole location, and it's really a tough pin to get at, but I hit a full wedge in there, you can see, and just right over the top of the flag. And now I got a little quick downhill right to left putt, that old bullseye of mine. And I couldn't believe I made that. If that didn't go in, it would have gone 4 feet by. That was a good way to finish. And, well, you know, at Oakmont that year, to shoot 140, right in position to win. Went to the first tee after warming up and opened up my favorite little spot for my yardage book, and it wasn't there. And then I went to the next one around the other side where my name is on the bag. It's not there either, and I'm thinking, oh my goodness, I don't have my yardage book. I gotta eyeball everything. And then the last thing you wanna do is eyeballing everything at Oakmont, which is so precise with the greens. You have to be dead precise to be able to get the ball close to the hole. And so I just freaked out. My wife went back through the US Open traffic and got me my yardage book as I walked off the ninth green. So thank goodness to my wife there, but that just really almost cost me the Open. No doubt about it, that yardage book. I was just not feeling it.
Johnny Miller is bunkered at 7. He's had all kinds of trouble, and he's 5 over after 6 holes.
The pressure was cooking on me, and I was choking, basically, is what it amounted to. And this is not an easy putt. Somehow I hung in there with it and lifted in the top side. That was really important. A par right then seemed like a birdie.
Another bogey for Miller, en route to a 76.
It crumbled. I was thinking this could be my US Open, and what a good story it'd be playing with Palmer and winning at Oakmont, and I was shattered. I'm 6 shots back, and I got all the best players in the world on the leaderboard. It's unbelievable who was in front of me. It was all the superstars. So I was thinking, well, I'm done. At that point, I was not thinking about having the chance to win. On Sunday morning, I said, pack up the bags, honey. We're going to catch a flight out right after the round, because I knew I had no chance. I was out on the practice tee, and I had like maybe 10 balls left to hit, and this voice said to me, open your stance way up. And it was like I always listened to the little still small voice my whole career. And so I opened the stance way up, and that sort of shortened my backswing a little and freed up my follow through. And I hit those last about 10 balls with that open stance. Absolutely perfect, right on line. Not a hook or a fade, dead straight. I'm walking to the first tee and I was like, well, that worked pretty good, but I don't know if I want to try it on the course. You know, sometimes you get these little keys and I thought, what the heck, I got nothing to lose.
Johnny Miller begins 3 over par, 6 strokes back and a tie for 13th. But is he ever hot? The first hole is a birdie.
I wish there was more coverage of that last round because I think my average shot with my driver was like 10 feet offline. My average iron shot was about 3 feet offline from where I wanted to hit it.
At the fourth, he barely misses an eagle.
After I birdied the first 4 holes, I said, you know, I got a chance to win. And here at the back of my neck stood up. Yeah, the 9th hole was my best buddy, and I played the left of the flag because it was a really hard flag to get to over that bunker. And this is really a very difficult putt to get within 5 feet.
That's a fine putt. He'll make his birdie.
I left myself just a straight up 1-foot putt, so that was a really nice birdie there on 9. And hit a 4-iron in there, right on line with the flag.
But he has a fine shot. Johnny Miller will have a pop at his birdie.
So that was a little bit of a surprise birdie right there. When my game was good, when I was on like that, I was really on tee to green.
Oh, and Johnny Miller is hitting a
for 13, about 4 to 5 feet away for another birdie.
You just got to take advantage of those kind of days because the next day might be like Saturday's round. So if you're going good, just keep aggressive.
Miller is 4 under 2. He has birdied 11, 12, and 13.
Now back in the middle of the 15th fairway, the sensational Johnny Miller. Shot of about 160 yards. Played 14 holes, he had 7 birdies and 7 pars.
And that leaves myself a nice uphill putt.
That 15 holes he played, 8 birdies, and a rest card. And now there's Johnny Miller leading the field all on his own. 15 holes.
I lay up in the middle of the fairway, went into the green with a full wedge. Right where you want to be, really not a hard putt at all. Everything, I've hit every green in regulation. Average birdie putt for the day is probably like 12 or 14 feet.
Here is Johnny Miller, who could break a couple of records. 18th tee, the 72nd hole, leading by a stroke. Oh, what a freewheeling swing.
It's as hard as I can swing. Still trying to get another birdie out of this round.
145 yards away, Chris. He had a tremendous drive.
This was as good a shot I hit all day. He's going right at the flag.
And it's coming in straight.
If it would have gone 1 foot farther in the air, it would have been stiff, but it hit that little crest and trickled back down, but right underneath the hole. I made under par for the day. I know it's a historical round, but I want to get one more birdie because Arnold Palmer's out there.
If John makes this putt, he'll shoot 62. It rims the hole, a 63.
Yeah, that putt there was as good as I could hit it. If it would have been a 16th of an inch to the right, it'd have gone in.
In Johnny Miller's miracle round, he doesn't have a single 5 on his scorecard.
Probably would like to save that ball. I had that feeling that I'd won. I just didn't think the guys could handle. Once I posted that score, to be able to finish under par, though, back nine, with maybe 4 or 5 holes to go, I just didn't see it happening. John Schlee made a good valiant effort, but he had a chance for the birdie there, but he was really the last of the competition that could have done something.
That was an awfully courageous shot, but only good enough for second place. 26-year-old Johnny Miller is the new national champion.
I just wanted to win it for my dad, to be honest with you. That's the one he wanted me to win the most. So when I did win at Oakmont, that was a lot of satisfaction there. Well, people will want to know what the highlight of my career, that was it right there. As far as a meaningful round that changed my life and set me apart a little bit from all the other really good young players. When you win the US Open, it's fantastic. But when you have a round like I did, the way I won the US Open, people really remember that round. That round was a historical round. It wasn't like a normal way of winning a US Open. It's different to shoot 63, but to do it on Sunday with Sunday pins. The Sunday pins are totally different than what they are on Thursday, Friday, Saturday. So it was, I don't want to sound like a braggart, but that was a heck of a round. Looking back on it, it was like a heavenly round. I mean, it was like it was meant to be for me and my career. It was just my day. That's all I can say. It was my day.